Hello friends, I am Dr. Chirag Chumaria. I am an oral and maxillofacial surgeon. I have been practicing dentistry since the past 4 years now. So today we shall be talking on diabetes and oral health. So we get a lot of patients who are concerned with bleeding, who are concerned with pain, but they don't concern themselves with what are their medical conditions. They feel that in cases of dentistry, the medical conditions would not be as important as it would otherwise be. So in that case, we need to understand about diabetes. What happens during diabetes? So in diabetes, we realize that it is actually the blood sugar levels in the body increases. Okay, and your body is incapable or is very inefficient in terms of processing those sugars and converting them into usable energy. So that is where the role of pancreas and the beta cells and the insulin comes into play. So what happens when you have raised blood sugar levels? When you have raised blood sugar levels, the chances of infection are high. You know, it is very simple to understand this concept. Bacteria, they need energy. How do they get energy? They get energy from glucose. If your blood has excess amount of glucose, the energy available for the bacteria or the infection will be higher. This is what happens to your whole body. Same thing happens to your oral cavity. Our oral cavity has millions of bacteria and they create a symbiotic relation with our body. Now when you have an uncontrolled diabetic condition, the amount of infection will increase, the amount of bacteria will increase in your capacity of the body to fight those infections will reduce. So we realize that in these kind of patients, you will have gingival swelling, that is swelling in the gums. You may have bleeding gums. You may have dull, gnawing kind of pain. Patient will complain specifically for periodontal pain. You will slowly start having tooth mobility. There are other effects of diabetes as well, but we will be talking about oral health today. So what happens then? What should you do? Now there are two case scenarios in this. One is, you know you are a diabetic and you know you have trouble, but you have kept your diabetes under control. In those cases where you know you are a diabetic and you have kept your diabetes under control with medications or injections or any way, which way, you should inform your dentist before your treatment starts. Usually in these cases, we make sure that we give an antibiotic cover in case of any kind of an invasive procedure. Second, we keep the treatment appointments in such a way that your peak level of insulin, that is your peak action of the medicine, does not coincide with our treatment level, because at the highest level of insulin, blood glucose level would reduce and your capacity to cope with the stress of the treatment would also reduce. The second condition. In second condition, you know you are a diabetic or you may not be aware of a diabetic, but your blood glucose levels are constantly high. Constantly unacceptable and you want to undergo a dental treatment. In this case, most of the practices today do get your blood reports done or they do an immediate needle prick test, okay, to check for your blood sugar levels. Ideally, it should be done 2 hours prior post treatment, post your needs. This would give a very good reading. If it is not possible to do it 2 hours post meals or before meals in the morning, then we do something called as a random blood sugar level. At any point of time, we do not accept a patient having more than 180 milligram of deciliter of glucose level in the body. We will then refer the patient to a diabetic specialist, okay, and they will get the blood levels in control, or the glucose levels in the blood in control. So once we are done with this, we understand that now you are a diabetic, you have raised blood glucose levels, we will get your diabetes under control, we will give you antibiotic cover and then proceed with the treatment. Now say we have done implants for you, we have done root canals for you and we have given you a bridge as well or a crown as well. It lasted for a few years, everything is okay. But now you have diabetes. You didn't have diabetes when we started the treatment or when we finished the treatment. But now after a few years, okay, as age has advanced, now we have diabetes. So what happens in this case? We see that because now you have diabetes and you have raised blood glucose levels, your body's capacity to fight off these bacteria reduces. So we realize that for years together, the implant treatment, the root canal treatment, they all were fine. But suddenly, this point, suddenly the implant starts to shake, or suddenly the root canal treated tooth starts to pain. These are all attributed to a medical condition. Second, you may start feeling that your prosthesis, the teeth, the crown which we have fixed, has started to become loose. Either it is shaking or it has just come out. One of the main reasons for that is that when the gums swell up, they apply constant pressure on your artificial prosthesis, and that pressure is enough to dislodge them from the mouth after a period of time. Hence, even if you get diabetes later on in your life, after your treatment is done, it is advisable to inform your dentist of the same.